What is love?
Love is. So to me, love is a lot of things.
Love is magical. Love is strong. Love is powerful. When you love something so much, you fight for it, you go for it, and you never quit. Because love always wins.
To me, love is the truth of who I really am. It's what's really inside me. It's what's in my heart. It's who I was created to be. And it's who you were created to be. And it's who God is. For God created us like God's self. And God is love, and we are love. And we are all here on this journey back to love, to remembering who we are. And we're here together to help each other get there. To love each other, to forgive each other, and to just embrace that truth of inside, we are all one.
Stop loving you. Why should I?
When I love a person, the way I see it is that I love, I'm concerned about their wellness and their happiness, and I will sacrifice my own wellness and happiness for their wellness and happiness. If I'm willing to do that, I know that I have love for that person.
Love is being able to go out on date nights with my husband.
Good food, good wine, good music, fabulous art, jewelry. Love is my family, my friends, my church.
Because I can't stop loving you. No, I can't stop loving you.
Love means happiness, craziness, and never having to say you're sorry.
Love is the good energy that flows throughout the universe, and it manifests itself in a number of ways: friendships, romance, acts of kindness. We put this energy out and it circulates throughout the universe.
I'm always here if you change, change your mind.
Love means joy and it also means heartache.
Love is sharing both the good and the bad.
Love to me means unconditional acceptance. Being there for somebody, whether they need a hug, or a shoulder to cry on, a listening ear, the little things.
For me, love is mutual respect. Love is finding ourselves in the reflection of other, in the mirror of your mirror.
It's patience, it's understanding, it's forgiving, it's hurt, it's pain. Love is every emotion.
Love is absolute and unconditional acceptance.
Love is absorbing people and things from not the path of the head, but the heart and the soul, and then continuing on that path to find understanding.
Doesn't have a typical look. Love could be anything from a flower to, you know, an errand or love can look like this.
Love looks like to me when I make my parents proud, when my partner laughs with me, when I see my children happy. That's when I see love.
Love looks like the ability to see someone else who does not look like us, who doesn't sound like us, and who maybe doesn't even think like us, but we're still able to connect with them.
Things that I love are things that bring me joy, things that bring me closer to oneness and to my truth, like being in nature and meditating and eating delicious fruits.
Love doesn't have a filter. It's beautiful, but it's imperfect and it's flawed, just like each and every one of us.
Self-love is a commitment that you are making to yourself, to choose yourself, to stay true to yourself, and to only be surrounded by respectful situations, words, and people.
I practice self-love by doing the things I love, like playing rugby, making music, and enjoying time with my family and my friends. And also by eating lots and lots of nice food.
How can we practice self-love? Take care of yourself. Instead of going out for ice cream, you can go for a walk, frozen yogurt, just taking care of yourself and, you know, not giving into, you know, negative thoughts like, not bringing yourself down. Making sure that you always tell yourself that you deserve the best. Giving yourself the best.
I practice self-love by constantly educating myself because knowledge is the number one gift that you can give yourself, and enlightenment is what makes the world a better place. So not only are you helping yourself, but you're also making sure that you are making the biggest contribution to society that you can.
Self-love for me looks like making sure that I am properly nourishing myself through, gosh, even little things like going to the spa for a beautiful facial, going to get a massage, going to listen to the waves come in and go out on the wonderful beaches. It's about finding awe and wonder throughout nature, our brothers and sisters.
I practice self-love by learning more about myself and then healing whatever's preventing happiness from within.
I practice self-love by working out and going for a pedicure.
What I do for self-love is that I take a little time out for myself each day, little bits and pieces here and there, so that I can manage my stress. Because a low stress me is good for me and it's good for everybody else. So what I'll do is I'll take a few minutes to do something I like. Maybe I'll stop and smell the roses. I will lollygag a little bit, or I'll take a few minutes to read up on something that interests me, or watch a couple of videos on YouTube. It's kind of curiosity things, not necessarily self-help or anything, but sometimes it includes that, sometimes it doesn't. But taking care of me is pretty simple. It's just knocking down the stress a peg or two every day in little bits.
I show self-love by doing things that I enjoy, by being kind and true to myself, by remembering who I am and honoring it, by dancing, by playing in the garden, by picking delicious fruits, by kissing the flowers. I show self-love by honoring my truth, by forgiving myself when I do something that doesn't honor my truth, by always, always just being me.
I practice self-love every day, reminding myself to accept who I've been in the past, to learn from that, to accept who I am now in my present, and to grow from that. And to remind myself that I will love and I will accept whoever I choose to become in the future. We're not perfect, but we are kind of beautiful in our own way.
I think we could show love to the world by not being so judgmental. You don't know what somebody is going through. They could look like they're the happiest they've ever been in their life, but deep down, they feel about this small. You can look after your neighbors, you know, go visit an elderly person.
Love to the world by actually listening to other people and then taking what they say and implementing it into our actions.
How we can show love to the world is by loving ourselves completely and unconditionally. And as we feel that love inside, we let it radiate out to all of our brothers, and we remember that we are one with everyone. And the fastest way for us to remember is to forgive ourselves and to forgive everyone. Because when we don't forgive, we clench, we feel in pain, we feel in darkness and separated. But when we forgive, we remember that we are all one, that we're all here together, that we're all here to love each other and help each other on this beautiful, beautiful journey that is life.
The way we can show more love to the world is by listening and learning. Ask questions instead of judge. Share a smile, share a hug. Share your wealth when you can.
Think about other people's feelings before you say some stupid crap, or think about how you can maybe help somebody out a little bit, and that is contagious. So if you help somebody and they help somebody else and then they help somebody and so forth, it's kind of like karma, but we drive the karma machine if we allow ourselves to. But the first thing about that is you have to stop being so selfish and thinking about yourself first. If you do that, you can turn it around and pay it forward.
We can all give back love to the world in remembering that we are all so connected. There is more that we can find in common than what divides us, as we all say. Remembering that we're all in this together. And as we feel this collective angst and birthing pains, we get to decide what we're going to birth. So how can we show love to the world? Through empathy, through patience, through kindness, and through listening. That's how we show love to the world.
Showing love to the world is kind of like a smile. When you smile at someone at the beginning of the day, it can enlighten their day, make it better, and they'll pass on a smile. Same with love. It's showing little acts of love that you could help someone else out. And it could be through statements also, such as a compliment. And then that will later trigger on to a domino effect throughout the world, and it'll start to engulf it. But it starts with the little things.
We can show more love to the world by not judging anyone and by being kind to everyone.
I believe we need to empower each other, support each other, root each other on. No negativity allowed, just all positive vibes. I feel like we should share our love towards each other by empowering each other. If we give each other good vibes, positive energy, cheering you on, rooting you on, you're gonna be happy and you're gonna feel love. And that person's gonna pass it on to someone else. So by showing love to one another, it just keeps the chain going. And then this world will be a normal, happy place. Show them that power of love. Oh, let's empower everybody. Show them that love is great.
Show love to the world by accepting people for who they are and bring positivity into this world.
I think showing love to the world is proving acceptance. And accepting everybody for their differences, things that set us apart from each other, things that make us unique and wonderful, things that make cultural tapestries. Different cultures, creeds, sexualities, skin color, whatever. Just acceptance and love. Every day, I go out of my way to do at least one nice thing for somebody who crosses my path, whether it be a simple compliment or helping somebody across the road, just something to help them through their day. If we all did that, imagine how wonderful this world would be.
Well, how do you think we should show love to the world?
Saying hi and hugging them.
Hugs mean love?
Uh-huh. Hug and kisses. And saying hi is being polite.
Be kind. Mm-hmm. Be kind to yourself. Be kind to other people.
Like me and my mom.
Like I said, you never know what someone's going through. You can have the picture-perfect life, but deep down below, everything can be bubbling. You could be the happiest person in the world. But everybody, at least once in their lives, is going to need help. A hand up, not a hand out. Is that good? Yeah?
Love.
And that's what love is.
L is for the way you look at me. O is for the only one I see. V is very, very extraordinary. E is even more than anyone that you adore can love, is all that I can give to you. Love is more.